Hi, this is Ruben, engineer and intern here at Saratech, and welcome to our tips and tricks tutorial series. Thank you for watching this video on customizing the contour plot in FEMAP. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe for more helpful tutorials. If you have any suggestions or specific requests for tutorials on topics you'd like us to create, please add them in the comments below. Additionally, if you have any questions about anything covered in this video, please be sure to ask your questions in the comments below. If you'd like to see other tutorials like this, please check out our other videos here on our YouTube channel. We also offer our online customer enablement series held on the first and third Thursday of each month. This is a free 30-minute live video tutorial series where our software experts will share their tips, techniques, and knowledge that will help you sharpen your skills. To sign up for this series, please contact us at info@saratech.com. So as you can see right here, we already have a contour plot displayed. So we want to go ahead and click on the model info, and down over here, we want to click on the post-processing. From here, we're going to want to go ahead and open up the contour. And as you can see, there are many options right here for our contour plot, but we're going to want to go ahead and focus on some more than others. So for our style, we're going to want to go ahead and work with contour. There are many other options that you can choose from. But for this video specifically, we're going to go with the contour. For our output set, this is just telling us what analysis is being displayed on our screen. And an important one is the output vector. So right here, you can click in this middle that says select output vector, and you can go ahead and choose to show what you want. So you have translation, constraint force, etc., etc. In our case, we're going to want to go ahead and click on the solid von Mises stress, and we're going to want to go ahead and continue with that. Go ahead and click OK. And we're going to go ahead and scroll down. This data conversion right here is also an important one. You have many options. You can go ahead and choose your liking, whatever you are focusing on. It all depends on what is going to be asked of you. In our case, we're going to go ahead and click on the no average centroid only, but for demonstration, I'll go ahead and click on average, and you can see up here that the numbers do change. So this is an important one to look out for, as you will go ahead and choose what is needed for your specific task. Moving on, we're going to go ahead and click on our type. Our type right here is elemental. This again will also change the number. So if you click on nodal, you can go ahead and see that it does change. In our case, we're going to work with elemental. Most of the time, I have found that elemental is the one that we continue using. So as you go down, we want to go ahead and go open up our levels. Our levels is an important one that we want to focus on, because this is really where you can get more into the customization. So our level mode is very important, because if you click on automatic, it will just show you what is produced from the results. But sometimes you need to get more specific, and you need to show things that are of interest to you. So in our case, what I want to focus on is our max says min threshold. So as you can see, our minimum level, we can go ahead and click 0, and our maximum level will go ahead and say is around 100,000 PSI. So we go ahead and enter that, and then we click enter. As you can see, this changes our contour a lot. So you can go ahead and play with this, and you'll see that it does change every time you input new bounds. That's an important one to know if you want to focus on a specific minimum slash maximum. Or like I said before, you can go ahead and have the automatic. I'll go ahead and leave the max min threshold. The color palette is basically what is shown right here. If you want to have different colors to represent different stresses, you can go ahead and do that as well. An important one right here is continuous colors, in my opinion, because this go ahead and will show you the exact color of each element. So if you have continuous colors, some of them might be blended. You might not get as accurate as a picture as you want, but if you go ahead and click continuous colors, each of them are banded and they are specific to certain numbers. If we go ahead and go to our label min slash max, right now we have no labels, but this might also be an important one, as it can demonstrate to, or it can show to your audience where your max slash min labels are. So we can either do a max slash min or a max or a min only. In our case, we'll go ahead and do max slash min, and you see that these numbers do pop up. However, these do kind of blend in with the colors of the contour, so it is a bit hard to see. As you can see, the one on the right, we can't even tell. So what we want to do right there is open up our legend. And we want to go ahead and click on the label color. We want to change that from contour colors to use view color. And as you can see, they become a lot easier to see compared to before. Now, the one on the bottom is still a bit hard to see, but it is a lot more legible than before. And over here on the right, we do see that this changes these colors as well. More on the on the legend, you can go ahead and change the position if you'd like. Center right, let's try bottom left. As you can see, it does change. In our case, we'll go ahead and leave that at center right, because it is a lot easier to see. So as you can see, there is a lot of customization that does go into the contour plots. It's just a matter of getting the necessary information that you need for your specific task. Other than that, that's going to do it for us today on customizing the contour plot in FEMAP. Thanks for watching the Tips and Tricks tutorial series. This is Ruben, engineering intern at Saratech. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, don't forget to check out our other support videos here on our YouTube channel and tune into our customer enablement series held on the first and third Thursday of each month. Thank you.
Thanks for checking out our channel. If you like what you saw, make sure to like and subscribe down below so you don't miss out on any new videos. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter for the latest engineering news and information. And to see all of our upcoming events, please visit our website at saratech.com/events.